A very good morning to all my dear students. Myself, Pooja Girotra, your SST teacher, is again here to teach you with a new lesson, agriculture. So students, today we are starting a new chapter, chapter number 14, agriculture. Let's study the chapter.
Okay. The process of preparing the land for the cultivation of crops for the rearing of livestock is called agriculture. So what is agriculture? When a land is prepared for growing crops. Students, what is the meaning of the word livestock? Livestock means the animals that are kept on farms, such as cows, pigs, sheep, etc. So preparing the land for the cultivation and for the rearing of livestock is called agriculture. Agriculture is one of the oldest occupations of human beings. It is considered as a primary activity for the humans. Oldest occupations, you have read in previous class also that early man's main occupation was agriculture only. They settled near the rivers. Why? Because they started doing the agriculture. About 50% of the people of the world are engaged in agriculture. About 2/3 of Indian people are also engaged in agriculture, directly or indirectly, for their livelihood. So for earning money, yes, as their main occupation, directly and indirectly people, they are connected to this work. And indirectly, like for example, many people, they do the supply of wheat, they do the supply of rice, sugar canes, like this. Now next, did you know climate has the greatest control over the arable land of the world? Climate plays a very important role in affecting agriculture. And arable land here, students, means the land which is capable of being plugged and which is used to grow crops, means fertile land only. That is called as arable land. Now, factors affecting agriculture. What are the factors which contribute an important role in the development of agriculture are soil, climate, irrigation, size of land, along with techniques and methods of farming. Irrigation here means supply, using different methods for irrigating the field, supplying the water to the fields. Now, we will study the first factor, climate. It is a basic factor for the development of agriculture. It controls the pattern of agriculture. The temperature and the amount of rainfall are important factors according to the place where crops grow. So what are the two important factors which play a very important role? Temperature of any place and amount of rainfall received on that place. Certain crops like rice grow in hot and wet climates, and certain crops like wheat grow in drier and cooler climates. So for growing different crops, different temperatures are needed, different climates are needed, and different amount of rainfall is also needed. Now second important factor, soil. Soil found in a place affects the kind of crops grown here. So soil plays a very important role. Clay soil is suitable for crops such as rice and cotton. Clay soil, students, clay soil, it is a soil which contains a high percentage of fine particles. Yes, and it retains good quality of moisture. That is called a clay soil. For growing rice and cotton, it retains water, means water content is very much high. Alluvial soil is ideal for agriculture and supports several kinds of crops, but the most important soil is alluvial soil, which is found near the rivers only. Yes, so this soil is the best suited for growing different types of crops. River banks are the most heavily cultivated areas around the world because they have deposits of alluvial soil. So why the agriculture it take place near the rivers only? Because river banks, they have a very good alluvial soil, because very fine particles are there. Yes, they are the deposits various sediments are there in that. So that is why people, they do the agriculture near the rivers. Sandy soil allows water to seep through rapidly. Sandy soil means it flows very slowly, means water, it flows very slowly into the soil. It is suited to grow crops like groundnut and millet. So sandy soil is best for growing groundnut and millets. Now next factor is relief. Plains, valleys, plateaus and deltas are more suitable for agriculture than mountains. So what are the reliefs? Plain, valleys, plateaus, so and deltas. These are more suitable. Hilly areas are suitable for cattle rearing. So hilly areas, you have seen on the mountains also, cattle rearing. Along with crops that need well-drained soils for crops like tea and coffee. So what is a well-drained soil? Well-drained soil has a loose structure and that allows for rapid movement of water. And in that soil, well-drained soil in which good quantity of moisture is there, which crops grown like tea and coffee. Now other factors besides this, other factors such as irrigation, size of land holding, transport, nearness of market, loan availability, etc. also affect the nature of agriculture practiced in an area. So these also play a very important role in the development of agriculture. That market should also be there, proper transport facility should be there, loan availability also should be there. Now we will study kinds of farming. Agriculture can be classified into two kinds on the basis of the availability of land. So on the availability of land, how much land is available for the cultivation of crops? On the basis of that, farming is divided into two parts, extensive agriculture and intensive agriculture. Now let's study extensive. In extensive agriculture, the amount of labor and capital employed are small as compared to the area being cultivated. So what happens in extensive agriculture, that labor, amount of labor and capital here refers to money, is very small. A high degree of mechanization is often found in it. And mechanization here means machinery. Various types of machines are required in this type of extensive agriculture. Why? Because there is scarcity of labor in that, in these areas where extensive agricultures are there. Extensive agriculture is there. This agriculture is generally practiced in sparsely populated areas. Sparsely populated areas are those areas where the population is very less. Yes, scattered. That is called the sparsely populated areas, not dense populated. Where agricultural land is abundant. Abundant here means that in sparsely populated areas, if population is less, then what happened? There will be availability of too much land. With respect to the demand for food. So what happens here, the land is more and the demand for food is less because of the less population. And because of the less population, there is scarcity of labor. No much labor is found in these type of farming areas. So that is why mechanization is often found here. Use of machines for doing cultivation is found in these type of farming. The farms under this agriculture are large and they yield more quantity of crops per unit of land in an area. This is known as single cropping. So in this type of agriculture, the area of the land is very large and more quantity of crops can be grown. This is known as single cropping. Single cropping here means that a single crop is grown on the same land. For example, wheat. Wheat is grown on the same land again and again, again and again. That is called a single cropping, repeatedly. When any crop is grown repeatedly, that is called a single cropping. cropping. Now we will study intensive agriculture. Intensive agriculture is opposite of extensive. Here labor is also too much, land size is also small, and demand for food is also high. Intensive agriculture, it is the most common in the thickly populated areas to fulfill the requirement of a large number of people. So it is found in the sparsely populated areas, but it is found in the densely populated areas where population is very much, and there, if the population is too much, then there will be a great demand for food. Growing of food should be more, that is always a question. In such areas, people cultivate small piece of land because they have limited land available for agriculture. So people here are very much in these areas. So what happened? Whatever the land they got, means any small holding of land is also there, they use that land for the cultivation. They use simple tools and more labor. So here labor is also too much, here labor is less. So here much of the labor is used in this type of intensive agriculture. They use simple tools and more labor. Sometimes rich farmers use modern techniques for agriculture. Climate of these areas is suitable and allows farmers to grow more than one crop in a year. Here single cropping is there. One crop is grown repeatedly. But here because of the fine climate, farmers they can grow more than one crop in a year. Rice is the main crop, but wheat, maize, pulses and oilseeds are other crops grown in such kind of agriculture. This agriculture is common in monsoon regions of South, Southeast and East Asia. So where these type of agriculture is found? In the monsoon regions of South. Southeast regions, like for example Indonesia, Sri Lanka, Thailand, and East Asia regions, like for example China, Japan, South Korea, Taiwan. So it is that comprises the East Asia. So these type of agriculture is found in the East Asia, Southeast region and South region. In India also such kind of agriculture is the most prevalent. So this intensive agriculture is also found in India. Agriculture may be grouped into four main types. These types are shifting, subsistence, commercial and plantation. So agriculture are of four types: shifting, subsistence, commercial and plantation.
Students, today I am giving you the homework. I am dictating five questions. You have to write down the answers. You have to find out the answers of these questions. First question: which Indian state produces the largest quantity of pulses? Pulses, you know. Which Indian state? Second question: which agency is responsible for distribution and storage of grain production in India? Second question. Third: which scheme was introduced by government for the benefit of farmers? Third: what is horticulture? And fourth question is, what is horticulture? Try to find out the answers of these questions. Meet you in the next tutorial. Till then, have a good day.